Hey Canucks fans, welcome to the first edition of WWTT. What were they thinking? I'm going to look at a clip, sometimes from a Canucks game, sometimes not. And instead of doing a detailed breakdown or expert analysis, I'm simply going to ask the question at various points through the clip. What were they thinking? So I hope you enjoy this. We're going to break down Auston Matthews, his second goal against the Vancouver Canucks in the Toronto Maple Leafs 5-1 victory against Vancouver. And don't forget that Matthews had already scored twice on Thursday night against the Canucks, and then he also potted one earlier in the game in that beautiful breakneck speed goal on Braden Holtby. So let's watch this once through, and then I'll talk about it.
Now played out.
Yeah, that block was a big one, though, because Hoglander had a lane.
Here's a giveaway, and Matthews in! Scores!
Okay, I think we all remember that goal, so let's talk about what happens in it. Now, the play starts innocently enough. You see the puck being cleared from Toronto's end, and Zach Hyman is giving chase to Quinn Hughes. Now, Hyman here is probably thinking, I don't think I'm going to beat Hughes to this puck. Hughes is probably thinking, oh gosh, Zach Hyman is bearing down on me. And then as you can see, the puck is going to Holtby, and Holtby positions his hands in a forehand position. And Holtby's thinking, I'm a good puck handler. I can get us out of this jam. So you can see that Holtby gets ready, gets himself ready for his forehand. And then what he does is he banks it off the boards, doesn't miss the ref. He kind of takes this angle towards the faceoff dot and out like this. Now, a lot of people are going to blame JT Miller for not skating back hard enough, but you got to remember, Auston Matthews is one of the fastest skaters in the game, and he's playing with so much confidence right now. Holtby, as a confident puck handler, could have actually put the puck to this corner in his forehand and then taken his chances, whether that's Hughes trying to get it or another player coming back. Or Holtby actually could have, if he was confident enough, gone backhand and put it right into the Sportsnet sign over here. But so again, he could have gone to the forehand over here, backhand here, but instead he puts it off the boards this way. Now you can see what happens here. Hughes and Hyman are not really factors, and we don't know what's going to happen next, because when we first saw this on the broadcast, all we saw was this open space, and we thought, okay, 50-50 chance that it's a Vancouver player. It should be a Vancouver player coming back for the puck next. But no, look at that. That is Auston Matthews. He's already got a good 4 or 5, maybe a 5 or 6 foot gap on JT Miller, kind of reminiscent of what happened last game. But what we didn't know is where they were in relation to the puck when Holtby first touched the puck. We know what happens here. So Matthews had to bobble the puck. You see how he's kind of settling the puck on the tape, which is a pretty good move. Miller's given up now. Now that 5 or 6 foot gap has become a 10 or 12 foot gap. Hughes and Hyman still hanging out in the corner there. And now Holtby's saying, oh gosh, I got to try and face this guy again. We know where Matthews is going. In fact, Hockey Night in Canada made a point about this. He doesn't always have to shoot high. His release is so quick that he is going 5-0. He's putting it along the ice. I'm not sure what Holtby's thinking here. I mean, it looks like he's looking to the ref for some help, but he actually should be looking down at the puck, because it's the puck that's going to basically pass him and go into between his legs and into the net. Of course it does. The ref gives the affirmative point. Holtby's still looking that way, maybe saying to the ref, why didn't you help me? Hughes and Hyman still hanging out together. And then Matthews starts. He doesn't even celebrate. Maybe it's because he doesn't want to rub it in, but he looks like he's going to cross-check this 80 years supporting hockey sign. That's what Matthews is doing with his hands. Then Matthews turns around and he does a quick spit. Do you see that? Do you see the way he did that emphatic spit? I'm not sure what he had in his mouth that he had to spit out, but yes, he did spit. He was thinking, I need to clear my mouth before I celebrate with my teammates. That's what he was thinking there. Holtby's thinking, gosh, this team is not that good right now, and I'm going to look over to the bench while I'm raising my stick, because I'm showing them not, if I just looked at the bench without raising my stick, it might not look as menacing, but I'm going to raise my stick too and show them, hey, I mean business. I'm not happy. Then the camera cuts to Chatfield here. I'm not sure why, because he didn't really have much to do with the play, although he was the one who couldn't hold it in the blue line. And maybe it's because he was going to be a -4 and he didn't, you know, touch the puck in the and create an offside in the third Toronto goal. Whatever. For whatever reason, they focus on Chatfield and that lock of hair that's hanging out on the back of his helmet. So I think Chatfield's thinking, why are you focusing on me right now? So then we got Matthews, and what's interesting is I want you to check this out. I think Matthews truly, as a good sportsman, doesn't want to rub it in, because what you're going to see next is probably the most disorganized flyby to a bench after a goal that I've ever seen. So let's look at it. Okay, So it starts off right. Usually the goal scorer is the first one to the bench, and we see that the first players there are ready to high five or medium five Matthews. So far, so good. But now let's look at what's happening here. You have Bogosian. You have the two Toronto defensemen here. They didn't even bother trying to get into the line. Then you have Matthews, and then you have Hyman and Nylander behind them. Hyman and Marner behind them. But look, you got Matty Malhotra probably studying notes or writing down how grateful he is that he doesn't play for the coach for the Canucks anymore. You have the coaches all watching the replay. And look at Jake Muzzin. He is... Maybe he doesn't want to get up 40 or 50 times a year for Auston Matthews. He doesn't even get off the bench. He just sits there and it doesn't take part in the flyby. So look what happens here. See, it's interesting. Muzzin kind of, you know, just kind of looking to, in that empty gap to see when Matthews flies by. Again, these two defensemen back here. We have the two forwards kind of behind. We have Malhotra still writing things down. We have the trainer getting ready to pick his nose, but realizing he's got a mask on. So there are so many different things happening here, but maybe Toronto's just disinterested at this point. And then, of course, we have Holtby. Holtby shooting a look back at the Canucks bench. Now, obviously, he's probably shooting a look back at JT Miller saying, why didn't you skate a bit harder? I can't believe this has happened, you know, twice in two games. But he could be thinking a lot of other things here as well. He could be thinking, man, what am I going to eat after the game tonight? He could be thinking, how did this team go further than us when in the bubble last year? He could be thinking, I think it's time to shave my beard. Or he could be thinking, I really hope Thatcher gets to play the next game. Whatever it is, he does not look happy. Now, of course, he's not holding his stick up above his head anymore because that gets a little tiring. He probably took a swig of water. But look at him. Now he's shaking his head. He's shaking his head saying, man, are we going to have to do this seven more times against the Toronto Maple Leafs team? And then he's looking at the replay and seeing this. So again, he looks good. That looks good, but he could have gone to either corner, but instead he puts it right up the boards and there. Okay, maybe that's a better look, is you see that Miller at least reaches out. He reaches out to make it look like he's trying, but he stopped moving his feet. You can see that the way that his feet are straddled like that, he is not moving his feet anymore, and there's no way he's going to catch Matthews already starting from a deficit. Then Matthews comes in and puts the puck between the legs once again. And we see one more time right here, Matthews' goal as he gets ready to cross-check that sign and as Holtby looks at the bench. So there you go. Some of the things that these guys could have been thinking of. Braden Holtby, Auston Matthews, Jake Muzzin, the Toronto bench. Subscribe if you'd like to, like this video if you'd like to, and join this channel as a member if you'd like to. Shout out to my Hall of Fame members, Jens95, SimAlexander, JustIncredible, and NucksFan number 29. Stay safe, stay healthy, take care of yourselves, and take care of each other. God bless, and go Canucks, go.